Hello, Erypony, it's Lisiana here. Link to my Divinian art in the description below and also for my Patreon if you like to do that. Warning, this video will contain pictures from Google that is not mine. Please go and give respect to the owners of these pictures and copyrights. And also it's going to contain my personal opinion about alicorns and how they make alicorns. So if you don't like stuff like that, click away or I'll stay. Yeah, here we go. 3, 2, 1. So with the newborn alicorn, shining armor, and Cadence baby flurry heart, I actually believe that there's going to be this way of getting a alicorn baby in a way. At first, I was actually thinking that alicorns was, as Rarity said, this princessy thing that you have to do and or extraordinary stuff that you have to do to earn, for example, wings or horn. And I thought that Luna was the one making unicorns and Celestia was the one making Pegasi. And, you know, Cadence was the one making earth ponies and crystal ponies. Now, this can still be a factor in the way that, you know, before a pony is born, I do believe still that Celestia gives wings if you're born at the morning, and Luna gives horn if you're born at night, and Cadence gives, you know, normal earth pony stuff if you're born in the middle of the day. Only especially things if you're born at, you know, twilight or sunset, or yeah, even I will say in a sunset glimmer, maybe? No. in the sunset of a glimmer, yeah. I really do believe that there is more potential of this, and I actually believe that all alicorns give a part of themselves, even their selves in general, or their magic to others when they want to make a alicorn. So I actually believe that was what happened with when Celestia turned, you know, Twilight into a alicorn, and that could also explain why she doesn't have that greater power anymore, or how to say that. I still feel like they have greater power. I just feel like maybe there have been some power exchange or something. So yeah, and also I do believe that Luna actually had a lot of power, or how to say that, restrained in the Tandabus. So I don't believe that she actually allowed herself to give away, you know, power, because she couldn't do that because of the Tandabus. Now the stuff with Cadence is a little bit more special, because I actually believe that the alicorn was born in, of course, love and, you know, family and stuff like that, and you know, they're both unicorns and one have wings, but I don't believe that Cadence actually always was a Pegasus or a unicorn. I do believe either that she gotten magic or she gotten wings, and that is how she became a alicorn. And I know that there's some background stories and stuff like that, but I actually feel like when a earth pony is born, I do believe that Cadence is the one that is choosing now if it's going to be strong or what its abilities is going to be. And then the pony is born, or how to say that. And the same goes for Celestia. I actually believe that she chooses that it's going to be a Pegasi, and then, you know, choosing the stuff that they're going to be good at, or how to say that, or a vague idea about what they're going to be good at. And the same for Luna. When you're born at night, I do believe that she will come and make you a unicorn, and then give you a vague, or give a vague idea about what you're going to be good at, and then you're going to be born. I don't believe that they have any, you know, power if they get children themselves. As you can see with Cadence, they were all surprised. A Alicorn baby is not something ever been seen before. So I actually believe that if, you know, Celestia or Luna had babies, I actually believe that there is a chance for them to be Alicorns. Or if Twilight had a filly, I actually also believe that that could also be a Alicorn. But I also believe that there could be the possibility of them being normal earth ponies, and you know, it's going to be just normal like every pony else, and that could also be an interesting factor to have in the community and stuff like that. But I really want some more explanation about, you know, Alicorn magic and how it works and stuff like that. But I do believe that Celestia and Luna got their powers, or how to say, from their parents. And I actually believe that their parents was the older generation to take care of Ponyville and making, you know, Pegasi and unicorns in day and night and stuff like that. And actually Starswell the Bearded was the one making normal earth ponies or stuff like that. I'm not quite sure how that could work, but I actually believe that there is some part of, you know, Celestia and Luna in all of the ponies and all of, you know, Ponyville, and also Celestia's parents. I do believe that there is a part of them in the world, and also maybe a part of Starswell the Bearded somewhere. I also believe that maybe, you know, Twilight was meant to be a earth pony because she was born in that time zone. But I do believe she was born before, you know, Cadence, and when, you know, Luna was sent to the moon, or how to say that. And who isn't to say that Starsworld was not the one, you know, to see her, give her her name, and be like, she's going to be magic or friendship. I really want a pony to take on my legacy or do something that I can't do myself, and put it into the world and choose the parents. I actually believe that Starsworld is very good at choosing parents for, you know, ponies, or how to say that. I also believe that is why, you know, Celestia doesn't, well, she knows about Twilight, but she doesn't know everything that is to know about her, because I actually believe that when she was sleeping, and Luna was sleeping, and also Cadence was sleeping, I do believe that Starsworld had something to do with, you know, the powers of, you know, time and stuff like that, and went back, and actually maybe it's a reincarnation of himself just in female form. I don't know, it sounds pretty weird, and this is just, you know, blabber, or how to say that. It's just something I really feel like I want some explanation, so I don't go and think about stuff like this. I know it's pretty much out there, but I actually believe now that Twilight also can give a part of herself to ponies and actually make them Alicorns, or in some sort of a way give them powers in some way. We have already seen this with the box and the elements of harmony and stuff like that. I do believe that they are all connected in some sort of weird way. But yeah, that was actually all for today. Do remember that inspiration is right around the corner. Do remember to take care of yourself and your loved ones. And that was actually all. Yeah, okay, bye.